Happy morning, students. I hope all are safe and doing good. Due to the worldwide spread of the deadliest virus, corona, and lockdown resumed by the city, DCE has instructed us to conduct online classes or upload the videos of our lecture. So, today I am here to solve problems on cash flow statement. If I am right, I have worked out 9 problems in cash flow statement. And this video consists of solution from the 10th problem. Before I could work out problems on cash flow statement, I would like to brief you all about the steps involved in preparation of cash flow statement. Step number 1. Prepare the ledger accounts for the adjustments given in the problem. Step number 2. Write the format of cash flow statement. The format of cash flow statement is as follows. Cash flow statement for the year ending. Then we are supposed to write cash flow from operating activities. This would be the first heading of cash flow statement. So under that, we are supposed to write the net profit or the retained earnings, whichever is given in the balance sheet. To this, we are supposed to add non-cash or non-operating expenses like depreciation, transfer to reserve, etc. Then you'll get net operating profit before working capital changes. To this, we have to add adjustments for changes in working capital, wherein we are going to add 2 items, increase in current liability and decrease in current assets. And we are supposed to deduct decrease in current liabilities and increase in current assets. From that, we have to less income tax paid. The answer that you get will be net cash inflow from operating activities if the answer is positive, and net cash outflow from operating activities if the answer is negative. The second head of cash flow statement will be cash flow from investing activities. So whenever we are writing the items under this head, it is better, students, note down that you are supposed to look into the asset side of balance sheet, wherein we have to look into the all fixed assets like purchase of land and building, sale of furniture, sale of building, etc. If there is purchase of any fixed assets, it should be written within brackets because the cash is going out. And if there is any sale of any fixed assets, it should be written without brackets. The final answer that you get would be either net cash outflow or inflow from investing activities. If it is a positive answer, it would be cash inflow. If it is negative, it would be cash outflow. The third head of cash flow statement is cash flow from investing activities. Here also, whenever you are writing the items under this head, you have to look into the liability side of balance sheet for all the fixed liabilities. Say for example, issue of equity shares, share premium, issue of debentures, it may be redemption of debentures, etc. Here also, whenever cash is going out, it should be written within brackets. If the cash is coming in, it should be written without brackets. And the answer that you get will be net cash inflow from financing activities. Then later on, we are supposed to find out net increase in cash or decrease in cash. If the answer is positive, it is increase. If it is negative, then you will get decrease in cash. To this, we are supposed to add opening balance of cash as it is given in the balance sheet. The answer that you ascertain would be the closing balance of cash, which would be given in the balance sheet. Third step is, we are supposed to post all the items recorded in ledger accounts to cash flow statement. And step number 4, posting of items left over in balance sheet, that is both on the assets and liability side of balance sheet, to the cash flow statement. Step number 5, posting or recording of adjustments left over in cash flow statement. Step number 6 would be finally completing the cash flow statement by ascertaining the closing balance of cash. It should be the balance as given in the balance sheet. We start working out the problem. So in this problem, we have adjustments for depreciation on land and building, plant and machinery and furniture. So which means that we have to prepare 3 ledger accounts. And when you come to liability side of balance sheet, we have provision for taxation and proposed dividend, which are considered to be non-current liabilities, and a ledger account should be prepared. So now, here is the ledger accounts that are prepared. First, you have land and building account. So as usual, students, you write the opening and closing balances of all the ledger accounts. So the adjustment given in the problem is depreciation. So by depreciation or by profit and loss account, it is 60,000. And balance the ledger accounts, you will get the balancing figure as 2,20,000, which is transferred to bank account. So this denotes purchase of land and building during the year, which is treated as an investing activity. Moving on to plant and machinery account, as usual, write the opening balance and closing balance given in the balance sheet. And the depreciation given in the adjustment is ₹50,000. Transfer this amount to profit and loss account. Balance the account, and the balancing figure that you get will be 1,04,600, again, which denotes purchase of plant and machinery during the year, which is treated as investing activity. The next account is furniture account. Write the opening and closing balance. The depreciation provided is 1,200, and the purchase of furniture during the year is 2,200, which is considered to be the balancing figure, and again, which is treated as an investing activity. One more thing that you have to note is the depreciation provided in all the assets account should be treated as operating activity. Now we'll move on to provision for taxation. As we all know that no adjustment is given for provision for taxation and proposed dividend. But still, we are supposed to prepare ledger account because these two items are treated as non-current liabilities. So write the opening and closing balance. So we have to assume that the provision for taxation made during the previous year has been paid during the current year. So when tax is paid, so credit what goes on. So provision for taxation account, debtor to bank account, 22,500. Balance the ledger account. The balancing figure that we get will be 40,500. This is transferred to profit and loss account. This is nothing but the provision made during the current year to be paid in the next year. Now move on to proposed dividend account. As usual, write the opening and closing balance. So since there is no adjustment, we have to assume that the dividend proposed during the previous year, that is 30,000, has been paid during the current year. So to bank account, 30,000. Balance the ledger account. So the balancing figure that you get will be 35,000. So this amount will be transferred to profit and loss account. This is the amount of dividend proposed during the current year to be paid in the next year. In ledger accounts, we are supposed to write down the format of cash flow statement. And the third step would be to post all the items that appear in ledger account to the cash flow statement. The first ledger account is land and building account. Towards the debit side, you have purchase of land and building. It's 2,20,000. As I told you, it is an investing activity. So look, you are supposed to write this item under the head cash flow from investing activity, purchase of land and building. Now come to credit side of land and building account. We have depreciation of ₹60,000. So this should be written under operating activities. Depreciation on land and building, 60,000. Now we'll move on to plant and machinery account. On the debit side, we have again purchase of plant and machinery, 1,04,600, which is considered to be an investing activity, which is shown under investing activity as purchase of plant and machinery, 1,04,600. So come to credit side of plant and machinery account. We have profit and loss account, that is by depreciation 50,000, which is treated as an operating activity. So depreciation on plant and machinery 50,000. Now we'll move on to next ledger account, furniture account. So to bank, that is purchase of furniture 2,200. So which is shown under investing activity, purchase of furniture 2,200. So now we have depreciation on furniture provided during the year 1,200, which is written under operating activities as depreciation on furniture 1,200. Now we'll move on to provision for taxation account. So the tax paid during the year is 22,500. This amount should be shown under operating activity. So here I've already shown tax paid. So the tax paid is 22,500. And coming to credit side of provision for taxation account, so we have provision for taxation made during the year to be paid in the next year, 40,500. This amount should be shown here under non-cash or non-operating expenses, provision for taxation. Now we'll move on to proposed dividend account. So the dividend paid during the year is ₹30,000. This dividend usually is paid on shares, so this will be shown under investing activity. So under investing activity, payment of dividend ₹30,000, which should be written within brackets. Why? Because cash is going out. And coming to credit side of proposed dividend account, we have dividend proposed during the year 35,000. So this amount should be shown under operating expenses, proposed dividend 35,000. So we have already posted all the items in ledger accounts. Now the next step will be to come to balance sheet. So on the liability side of balance sheet, we have equity share capital, previous year 3 lakh, current year 3,50,000, or the opening and closing balance. So this denotes that there is issue of shares. So issue of shares should be shown under investing financing activity. So issue of equity shares 50,000. Next you have share premium. So share premium amount collected is rupees 30,000. Again this amount should be shown under in financing activity. Then you have general reserve. So the opening balance is 45,000 and the closing balance is 65,000. It denotes that there is a transfer to reserves made. So this should be shown under operating expenses as transfer to reserve, that is 20,000. So profit and loss account, this is the net profit which we are supposed to show under cash flow from operating activities as net profit 50,800. So sundry creditors. So if you look into the opening balance, it is 85,000, closing balance is 90,700. So as for the format, whenever there is increase in current liability, it should be added. So you can see here, creditors, it is added here, 5,700. So next item, proposed dividend and provision for taxation, wherein we have already prepared ledger accounts and it is done. Now we'll move on to asset side of balance sheet. So we have land and building. Land and building, already we have prepared ledger account and then has been posted to the cash flow statement. Similarly, plant and machinery and furniture account. Now we have stock. Stock in the beginning of the year it is 82,400 and in the current year it is 95,700. So now there has been increase in current assets. So this increase in current assets should be shown under operating activities. That is increase in current assets, stock 13,300. We have debtors, previous year 75,000, current year 85,500. Again we have an increase in current asset. This amount also should be shown under operating activities, like debtors 10,500. These two items should be deducted. And now the bank balance, which has to be adjusted in the end. Now we'll move on to additional information. So all these three additional information have been already considered and the ledger accounts have been prepared. So now it is time for us to complete this cash flow statement. So cash flow statement from cash flow from operating activities, I've already calculated, and the cash inflow from operating activities is 2,16,900, and cash flow from investing activity is, it is cash outflow 3,26,800, and then cash outflow from financing activity is 1,20,000. So that we have net increase in cash of rupees 10,100. To this we have to add opening balance of cash of rupees 34,200. So the balance that you get will be 44,300, which is nothing but the closing balance of cash 44,300 given in the balance sheet. With this we will complete this 10th problem.